If you're a contractor and you're dealing with a lot of prospects that want to ball out on a really frugal budget, this video is for you because it's going to show you exactly how to deal with people like this. Check it out. Hey, this is Logan Schinholster with Contractor Growth Network, and I want to walk you through exactly why prospects, leads, why they seem to beat you up on price. I want to walk through first why they do that, and then one way that we really hammer home this area of concern, so that way when clients call and future prospects call you, they're not tire kickers. They're not trying to get, you know, all this stuff for very cheap, because they typically understand what you cost. So let's just first start off with why customers and future clients and whatever you want to call them, why they always seem to come in so cheap. All right. And the reason is we as small business owners don't always do that great of a job explaining what stuff costs up front. With a car, typically we all know what a car costs, right? Or a cheeseburger. We have a good understanding of what a cheeseburger when we go to a restaurant is going to cost. McDonald's does an amazing job where, you know, their prices are everywhere, right? They're on the TV commercials, they're in the ads, they're on billboards. You effectively know what you're spending before you even walk in there. Yet and that's what we love about these places, is we know we're gonna walk into McDonald's and we know we're gonna spend, you know, $1, $2, $3 on a burger and that's it. We're not walking in there going, man, I wonder if it's gonna be a dollar or if this is gonna be $45 for a cheeseburger. Same with cars. Cars are very upfront about what stuff costs. All right, now what that does is it commoditizes them a tiny bit, because all like a lot of the dealerships sell similar cars. But with you and your work, if you already know how you're different, you already know how you're unique, maybe you have a different style, what happens is people love your style, they fall in love with what you do, but they don't know what it costs. So in their head, they're thinking something completely different than what you charge. So let's say you average $50,000 for a kitchen, and somebody comes in and they want to spend $15,000. Well, we as craftsmen, everybody gets frustrated. They go, well, you're so cheap. What do you mean it only costs 15? But in fact, they don't know what it costs. They don't know what the material costs or what you pay your employees, or hell, they don't even know what your overhead is. So they just kind of assume it's on the cheaper end, which is why they get all excited. So it's not actually their fault. Plus, if you really want to dive a little bit deeper into the psychology of this, you're the one that places the value on your own services. So if somebody says, well, it's not worth that much, maybe you just outpriced yourself. And I'm not saying cut your prices, but I'm saying you are the one that set the value of your work. And if you don't do a strong enough job of showing and explaining that value, then they have every right to say it's not worth that much, because what you're setting is a subjective thing. It's not like, you know, like the kitchen remodeling gods came down and said, this is the MSRP of a kitchen remodeling project. This is you doing it. So you have to be very understanding that that is the case. And when you set it and somebody says it's not worth that much, you as a natural salesman need to show them and explain to them why it's worth this much money. And some people are just gonna say no, no matter what, right? It doesn't matter how much convincing and how much they say, okay, I'm in, then they're just never gonna move forward, because 50 is never gonna be in their budget. Then you have other people that are, no matter what you say, they're gonna move forward. But a lot of people are actually maybes. They're on the line of, well, I don't really know if this is for me. So there's three different groups of people. However, you have to truly understand that a lot of what happens and why we perceive clients as cheap is simply for the fact that they just don't know what this stuff costs, okay? So how do we deal with that? Well, we are very, very pro put your pricing out there, because what that does is that is going to limit the amount of people that are way off your mark that come in. All right, now if somebody has no idea what you cost and you're going through this amazing estimate with them, they're loving it, they're loving the samples, they're feeling you big time, and you're like, I know it, I'm in, they're moving forward. What happens is, unless you do this over the phone, which I'll talk about in a second, you go home, you send them over an estimate, you spent 2 hours working out the estimate, it's perfectly done, you send it over, no answer. 3 days go by, no answer. And the fourth day you call them, they don't answer. The fifth day you call them because you're like, what the hell is going on? You get one of those texts that says, hey, I can't talk right now, I'll call you later. And guess what happens? They never call you later because your estimate was so far outside of their range that they are now kind of embarrassed that they don't even want to talk to you. By having your pricing out there up front, that will filter out a lot of those people. So by the time that they understand what you cost and where to go from there, they're ready to go. So for example, this is like, I've done a YouTube video all about this specific website, but they focus on, you know, different remodeling projects, different rooms, but you know, let's just go past all the emotional side, which all of this stuff is selling them, right? The layout of this page is, you know, a space that just feels right. You know, how many dinner nights have you passed because your kitchen is not big enough, right? Then we talk about the actual process of working together. And then we talk more about the emotion. It fits your lifestyle. Here are some unique things that you can do to your kitchen. So we're building it up, building it up, building it up. So as people are walking down this page, they're like, holy shit, I need that. I need this website. And then when they get to the bottom, they see what it costs. So if they're thinking, you know, $4,000, then this immediately kicks them out. They're not coming in for, you know, a $40,000 kitchen with a $4,000 budget because they realize on the lowest end of projects, it's $12,500 just to do a minor upgrade to the kitchen. So this is going to naturally filter out a lot of people. A lot of people that it's not necessarily that you're gonna be able to be this amazing salesman and convince them that they need to spend more. These are people that are never gonna buy from you. And here's why. They are just so far out of your range. They are at 4,000, 5,000, 6,000, or maybe they're at 12,500, but they want the 38,500 option for 12,500. No matter how much you talk to them, you're not gonna persuade somebody to increase their budget by over three times the amount. It's just not gonna happen. Unless you've got something amazing going on, you're this killer salesman, I don't know, you have to be special in some way, but this is going to filter out a lot of those people. So people that are coming in are understanding of what it costs when working with you. All right, so up top, we've shown the value, and then at the bottom, we've said, this is what the value is worth. Now we also have an aspect of the financing, so we could help you finance it, we can talk about that, but we really wanna filter people out. All right, so that's the first step. The second step is doing this over the phone. So when somebody fills out a contact form, they're ready to go, bring up the budget, right? Talk about this. And this is exactly what the Contractor Sales Academy is all about, is because I talk to contractors that are like, yeah, I drive out an hour, talk to them for an hour and a half, drive back another hour. That's 3.5 hours right there just for you to write up the estimate and send it over. Now you're gonna have less people that are, you know, calling you up, but you still every so often are gonna have somebody who says, well, my range, my budget fits in this bracket, but then they end up not understanding exactly what goes into a $15,000 kitchen, and they want the Taj Mahal for $15,000. So by calling them up and having just a basic conversation over the phone of what specifically are you looking for, when they just describe it, you generally have a ballpark of, well, it's gonna fall between this and this range. So you can say, hey, look, I know that the average cost on the website says 17,500. What you're talking about is something closer to 23 to 26 grand, somewhere in that range. What do you think about that? And they may go, okay, that sounds fine. That's exactly kind of what I was thinking. Or they're like, well, I was thinking, you know, this is gonna be 12,500. And then you gotta have that conversation. But again, what you're doing is you are upfront just having a basic conversation, and clients actually love this because you're not wasting their time. And for as much as it sucks for you to get ghosted, it's also awkward for them because nobody likes telling other people no. That's not fun for us, which is why we then avoid the salesman who's calling back over and over and over. It'd be much easier if we just said, no, it's not gonna work. Sorry, we're out. But we love to avoid this because people just don't want confrontation. So, with that being said, a amazing way to filter out a lot of these people is to have your pricing up front. Let them know all you really need is, you know, low end, high end, middle ground, but that is going to really get the people out. Now, here's one thing to understand is that if the rest of this page is not done correctly, then these prices just may seem astronomically high, because if you're a generic if all your marketing is generic and your branding is generic, then they're gonna look at your prices as well. They sell a generic product for a very high dollar amount, I'm out. So the rest of it has to be done correctly for this to then make sense and people go, okay, that's worth it. Because otherwise these prices will seem out of their range, even if they're not, just because everything else that you're doing is very generic. So if you're sick of dealing with this stuff, this is the way to do it. If you want to get rid of the low end people that just don't understand your value, have your pricing up front, talk about it, talk about, and be ready to talk about why things cost what they cost, because humans, like, we can rationalize it and that stuff will make sense. But just be prepared of it. Don't shy away from it, because at some point you're gonna have to bring up costs. And if you rely on the estimate to do all the talking, you're in trouble. If you want a site like this, where it will filter out those people, so everybody who's coming in, they know ballpark of what you cost, so it's not this huge shocking factor, which does two things. One, it way increases your close rate, and two, it keeps your head in the game, because the last thing that you want is to go on 15 estimates in a row, all for people that are way outside of your normal ideal client, because that's gonna kill your mojo. Head to contractorgrowthnetwork.com, check out what we got with the websites, and let's have a conversation, because we have this amazing 3P program that is dedicated to helping you generate the quality leads that you actually want and need. So then that way you're not dealing with tire kickers left and right. ContractorGrowthNetwork.com. See you over there.